Hi friends, in this video we will discuss about the science and technology current affairs. First one, defense technology. Defense technology, current affairs regarding the defense technologies. First one, quick reaction surface to air missiles. DRDO has successfully test fired indigenously developed quick reaction surface to air missiles from a test range of Odisha coast. So what is this QRSAM? It has been developed to replace the Akash missile defense system and has 360-degree coverage. It uses solid fuel propellant and has a strike range of 25 to 30 kilometers with capability of hitting multiple targets. It is capable of hitting the low-flying objects. So important points are, quick reaction surface-to-air missiles are indigenously developed by DRDO. It has been developed to replace the Akash missile defense system. It has 360-degree coverage. It uses solid fuel propellant. Strike range 25 to 30 kilometers. Capability of hitting multiple targets. And it has it is capable of hitting the low flying objects also. So next one, MiG-27. It is an aircraft which has recently been retired from Indian Air Force. It is commissioned in Indian Air Force in 1985. It was due to the jet's heroics during the Kargil War that the aircraft earned the nickname Bahadur. It is a single engine, single seater, tactical strike fighter aircraft. Initially developed in the erstwhile Soviet Union and later indigenously manufactured by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited in India. It is primarily a ground attack aircraft whose main role is to conduct precision airstrikes in battle while tackling the adversary's air defenses. Important points, it has been nicknamed as Bahadur. It is a single engine, single seater, tactical strike fighter aircraft. It was initially developed by Soviet Union and later indigenously developed by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Then it is primarily a ground attack aircraft. Next topic, Prithvi 2 missile. It is a surface-to-surface tactical missile with a strike range of 350 kilometers. It is developed by DRDO under Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. It is capable of carrying 500 to 1000 kilogram of warheads. It can carry both conventional as well as nuclear warheads. The state-of-art missile is powered by liquid propulsion twin engines. It uses an advanced inertial guidance system with maneuvering orbit to hit its target. Important points, it is surface-to-surface with a strike range of 350 kilometers, developed by DRDO under Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. Capable of carrying 500 to 1000 kilograms of warheads, both conventional as well as nuclear. It is powered by liquid propulsion twin engines. It uses an advanced inertial guidance system with maneuvering orbit to hit its orbit. Next topic, Pinaka guided weapons. Indigenously developed Pinaka guided weapon system. It has recently been successfully tested. Pinaka rocket systems are developed by DRDO. The rocket system was named after Pinaka, the bow of Lord Shiva. It was initially 30 to 40 kilometer range target, but its range was increased to 70 to 80 kilometer with Pinaka Mark II. Important points, indigenously developed by DRDO, named after the bow of Lord Shiva. Strike range initially 30 to 40, but now increased to 70 to 80 kilometers with Pinaka Mark II. Then BrahMos missile. It flies almost 3 times the speed of sound at Mach 2.8. The missile has been jointly developed with Russia and it is named after the rivers Brahmaputra and Moskva in Russia. It is a medium range ramjet supersonic cruise missile and has a range of 290 kilometers. It is extremely difficult to intercept by surface to air missiles deployed on leading warships around the world. BrahMos is the fastest cruise missile of its class in the world. The range of BrahMos missile can be extended up to 40 kilometers because certain technical restrictions were lifted after India became a full member of the MTCR, that is Missile Technology Control Region, in 2016. It is a multi-platform, that is it can launch from land, air and sea, and multi-capability missile with pinpoint accuracy that works in both day and night irrespective of the weather conditions. The missile is operational with the Indian Army, Navy and Air Force. So what are the important points? Speed of Mach 2.8, jointly developed with Russia, medium range, ramjet, supersonic, cruise missile, and range to 290 kilometers, can be extended up to 400 kilometers because India has become a full member of MTCR. BrahMos is the fastest cruise missile of its class in the world. It is a multi-platform, that is it can be launched from land, air and sea, and multi-capability with pinpoint accuracy. It works in both day and light irrespective of the weather conditions. The missile is operational with the Indian Army, Navy and Air Force. The BrahMos missile is very important for UPSC prelims as well as mains, irrespective of the years. And next topic, air independent propulsion system. Indigenous air independent propulsion system to enhance the endurance of conventional submarines being developed by DRDO reached a milestone with the successful operation of a land-based prototype. All Scorpion submarines of the Navy are planned to be equipped with an AIP model in due course. So what is air independent propulsion? It is a technology which allows a non-nuclear submarine to operate without the need to access atmospheric oxygen, that is by surfacing or using a snorkel. It is a technology which allows a non-nuclear submarine to operate without the need to access atmospheric oxygen. It can augment or replace the diesel-electric propulsion system of non-nuclear vessels. It is based on the combustion of stored oxygen and ethanol to augment battery-powered propulsion. Significance: it enables a submarine to generate electricity for services and battery charging and propulsion while completely submerged. It also generates electricity, powering a submarine to operate, and also generate oxygen, lighting and amenities for crew. Non-nuclear submarines running on battery power or AIP can be virtually silent. So it will be very difficult for the enemies to find the submarine, to locate the submarine. So what are the important topics? Air independent propulsion allows a non-nuclear submarine to operate without the need to access atmospheric oxygen. It can augment or replace the diesel electric propulsion system based on the combustion of stored oxygen and ethanol to augment battery powered propulsion. It enables a submarine to generate electricity for services and battery charging and propulsion while completely submerged. AIP systems also generate electricity, powering a submarine to operate, and also generate oxygen, lighting and amenities for crew. So it can be virtually silent. Next topic, man-portable anti-tank guided missile. It is an Indian third generation fire and forget anti-tank guided missile. It is developed by DRDO. Incorporated with state-of-the-art infrared imaging seeker along with advanced avionics. So what are the list of India's anti-tank guided missile? DRDO anti-tank missile, Amoga missile, Nag missile, man-portable anti-tank guided missile. So DRDO anti-tank missile, Amoga missile, Nag missile, man-portable anti-tank guided missile. So all these are India's recent anti-tank guided missiles. So important points: it is an Indian third generation fire and forget and anti-tank guided missile developed by DRDO, incorporated with state-of-art infrared imaging seeker along with advanced avionics. Next topic, NAG, anti-tank guided missile, ATGM, NAG anti-tank guided missile. It is a third generation anti-tank guided missile. NAG missile is a third generation anti-tank guided missile which has top attack capabilities that can effectively engage and destroy all known enemy tanks during day as well as night. It uses an imaging infrared seeker in lock-on before launch mode. It is launched from NAG missile carrier, that is Namika, which is capable of carrying up to 6 combat missiles. Range is important, minimum 500 meters and maximum 4 kilometers. It is developed by DRDO. NAG important points, third generation anti-tank guided missile. It has top attack capabilities that can effectively engage and destroy all known enemy tanks during day as well as nights. And it uses imaging infrared seeker in lock-on before launch mode. Lock-on before launch mode. It is launched from NAG missile carrier, that is Namika. It is capable of carrying up to 6 combat missiles. Range, minimum 500 kilometers and maximum 4 kilometers. Developed by DRDO. Next topic, Rustam 2 drone. Rustam 2 drone is a medium altitude, long endurance, unmanned aerial vehicle developed by DRDO. It is a medium altitude, long endurance, unmanned aerial vehicle developed by DRDO. The objective is to carry out surveillance for the armed forces with an endurance of 24 hours. It was developed for use by all three services of the Indian Armed Forces, primarily for ISR operations, that is intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance operations. The medium altitude prototype, it is a medium altitude prototype and it can fly at over 22,000 feet and is a male UAV, medium altitude long endurance UAV. Male means medium altitude long endurance UAV that has an approximate flight time of 20 hours. It can fly around 280 kilometers per hour and carry a variety of payloads like medium range electro-optic, long range electro-optic, synthetic aperture radar, electronic intelligence. So important points, medium altitude, it is a male UAV, medium altitude, long endurance, unmanned aerial vehicle developed by DRDO with an endurance of around 24 hours. It can carry out surveillance for all the three armed forces. It can fly over 22,000 feet, approximate flight time 20 hours. It can fly at around 280 kilometers per hour. Then Astra missile, it is indigenously developed beyond visual range air-to-air missile. First air-to-air missile developed by India. Astra is the first air-to-air missile developed by India. It is an all-weather state-of-the-art missile developed by DRDO. And it can engage and destroy enemy aircraft at supersonic speed, that is 1.2 Mach to 1.4 Mach in head-on, up to 80 kilometers and tail chase up to 20 kilometers. In head-on up to 80 kilometers and in tail chase modes it is up to 20 kilometers. It is 3.8 meters tall. Astra is 3.8 meters tall and it's a radar homing missile and the smallest of the DRDO developed missiles. It is the smallest of the DRDO developed missiles and can be launched from different altitudes. It can reach up to 110 kilometers when fired from an altitude of 15 kilometers. It can reach up to 44 kilometers when launched from an altitude of 8 kilometers and 21 kilometers from sea level. 110 kilometer from 15 kilometers, 44 kilometer altitude, height 42 kilometers from 8 kilometers and 21 kilometers when fired from sea level. It features mid-course inertial guidance with terminal active radar homing. Astra has been integrated with Indian Air Force Sukhoi Su-30 Mk-1 and will be integrated with Dassault Mirage 2000, HAL, Tejas and Mikoyan MiG-29 in the future. Important points of Astra missile. It is a indigenously developed beyond visual range air-to-air missile, first air-to-air missile developed by India, all-weather state-of-the-art missile developed by DRDO, supersonic speed 1.2 to 1.4, in head-on up to 80 km, in tail chase mode up to 20 km, 3.8 meter tall, and 110 km. It can reach up to 110 km when fired from altitude of 15, 44 km when launched from 8 km altitude, and 21 when fired from sea level. It features mid-course inertial guidance with terminal active radar homing. Astra has been integrated with Indian Air Force Sukhoi Su Mk-1 and will be integrated with various other aircrafts also. Next topic, spike missile. Indian Army places order for Israel anti-tank spike missile. Next topic, spike missile. Indian Army places order for Israeli anti-tank spike missiles. Israeli anti-tank spike missiles from Israel are multi-platform, cutting-edge, precise, multi-mission and multi-range electro-optical missiles. These missiles have capabilities of fire, observe, update, fire and forget, as well as allowing attack of hidden targets. Israeli anti-tank spike missiles are manufactured by Rafael Advanced Defense Systems Limited. These missiles have the capability of targeting anything at a range of 4 kilometers. These can be deployed in both plains and mountains. Spike missile, important points. It is from Israel and multi-platform, cutting-edge precise, multi-mission and multi-range electro-optical missiles. These missiles have capabilities of fire, observe, update, fire and forget, as well as allowing attack of hidden targets. Manufactured by Rafael Advanced Defense Systems Limited of Israel. And these missiles have the capability of targeting anything at the range of 4 kilometers. Can be deployed in both plains and mountains. Next topic, Varaha. Varaha is an Indian Coast Guard ship commissioned recently. It will enhance the surveillance and patrolling capabilities of Indian Coast Guard and reinforce their role in sentinels of our seas. And reinforce their role as sentinels of our seas. It is the fourth in the series of 7 98-meter offshore patrol vessels of Indian Coast Guard. It has been designed and indigenously built by Larso and Dobro at its Kattupalli ship building yard in North Chennai. Important points, Varaha is an Indian Coast Guard ship. It will enhance the surveillance and patrolling capabilities of Indian Coast Guard and reinforce their role as sentinels of our seas. It is the fourth in series of 7 98-meter offshore patrol vessels, indigenously built by Larso and Toubro. Next topic, submarine Kandheri. Mazagon Dock Shipbuilders Limited delivers second Scorpion submarine. Kandheri is a Scorpion submarine. Mazagon Dock Limited at Mumbai is manufacturing 6 Scorpion submarines under technology transfer from Naval Group of France under a 2005 contract. The submarine Kandheri is named after the wide-snouted sawfish, which is a deadly sea predator of the Great Indian Ocean. The first submarine Kandheri was commissioned in the Indian Navy on 6 December 1968 and decommissioned in October 1989 after more than 20 years of service to the nation. names of the upcoming submarines: Karanj, Vela, Vagir, Vakshir. So important points about submarine Kandheri. It is a Scorpion submarine Kandheri, developed by Mazagon Dock Limited, Mumbai, and under the technology transfer from Naval Group of France. Kandheri is named after the white snouted sawfish. New names of upcoming submarines: Karanj, Vela, Vagir, and Vakshir. Next topic: India's anti-satellite missile, which is ASAT. Mission Shakti is a joint program of DRDO and ISRO. As part of the mission, an anti-satellite weapon, ASAT weapon, was launched and targeted an Indian satellite which has been decommissioned. The target of the test was a satellite present in a low Earth orbit. The test sparked concerns regarding the creation of space debris. So what is the significance? India is only the fourth country to acquire such a specialized and modern capability, and entire effort is indigenous. Till now, only US, Russia and China had the capability to hit a live target in space. India's successful demonstration of the ASAT capability is said to signify its ability to intercept an intercontinental ballistic missile. So what is a space debris? It is a space junk. Space junk is an ever-growing problem with more than 7,500 tons of redundant hardware now thought to be circling the Earth, ranging from old rocket bodies and different spacecraft to screws and even flux of paints. So this material poses a collision hazard to the operational missions. The rising population of space debris increases the potential danger to all space vehicles, but essentially to the International Space Station, space shuttles, satellites and other spacecraft. So technologies that can tackle the problem in future are NASA's Space Debris Sensor. It orbits the Earth on the International Space Station. The sensor was attached to the outside of the space station's European Columbus module. It will detect millimeter-sized piece of debris for at least 2 years, providing information on whatever hits it, such as size, density, velocity, orbit, and will determine whether the impacting object is from space or a man-made piece of space debris. Remove debris. It is a satellite containing two CubeSats that will release simulated space debris so that it can then demonstrate several ways of retrieving them. Then deorbit mission. Deorbit is a planned European Space Agency active space debris removal mission developed as part of their Clean Space Initiative. So the Clean Space Initiative and deorbit mission are related to European Space Agency. Other technologies include moving objects with a powerful laser beam. So it is important to start doing that soon, because current scientific estimates predict that without active debris removal, certain orbits will become unusual over the coming decades. So what are the important points for India's anti-satellite mission? Mission Shakti is a joint program of DRDO and ISRO. Anti-satellite weapon, as part of this mission, anti-satellite, that is ASAT weapon, was launched and targeted an Indian satellite which had been decommissioned. The target satellite was present in a low Earth orbit. Significance: India is only the fourth country to do so. The ability to intercept an anti-continental ballistic missile. India's successful demonstration of ASAT capability is said to signify its ability to intercept an intercontinental ballistic missile. So technologies that can tackle the problem are NASA's Space Debris Sensor, Remove Debris, Deorbit Mission of European Space Agency as part of Clean Space Initiative, and laser beams. Next topic: Baba Kavach. India's first, lightest and indigenous bulletproof jacket, Baba Kavach, from Ordnance Factory Board, Gates Node of MHA. Developed by Ordnance Factory Board and Nidani, this developed by OFB and Midani. State-of-art jacket can withstand 7.62mm hard steel core or bullets fired from AK-47 rifle, 5.56mm inches bullet, and even the recently decommissioned 7.65mm bullet of self-loading rifle. It is half kg lesser than the prescribed weight of MHA along with the 360 degree protection and has achieved the protection level of NIJ 3+. Baba Kavach only weighs 9.2 kg and is a major breakthrough for the Indian Armed Forces. Baba Kavach is India's first lightest and indigenous bulletproof jacket developed by Ordnance Factory Board and Midani. Akash missile. Next topic, Akash missile. DRDO successfully test fired Akash MK-1S missile. It is a surface to air anti aircraft missile with a strike range of 25 km and capability to carry warhead of 60 kg. It can reach an altitude of 18 km and can be fired from both tracked and wheeled platforms. The missile is guided by a phased array fire control radar called Rajendra. Which is termed as battery level radar with their tracking range of about 60 km. It is capable of striking down enemy fighter jets and drones very effectively and accurately. Akash surface-to-air missile was designed to intercept any enemy aircraft and missiles from distance of about 18 to 30 kilometers. Akash missile, important points, DRDO successfully test-fired it. It is a surface-to-air anti-aircraft missile, strike range of 25 kilometers and capability to carry warhead of 60 kilometers. The next topic, Agni 2 missile. India recently conducted surface-to-surface medium-range nuclear-capable missile, the trial of Agni 2, the first night trial of Agni 2. It is Agni 2 is surface-to-surface medium-range nuclear-capable missile, strike range 2000 km. It is an intermediate-range ballistic missile. Two-stage, it has already been inducted in the armed forces. It is a two-stage missile equipped with advanced high-accuracy navigation system and was guided by a novel state-of-art command and propelled by solid rocket propellant system. Agni 2 was developed by Advanced System Laboratory along with other DRDO laboratories and integrated by the Bharat Dynamics Limited, Hyderabad. Agni 2 is part of Agni series of missiles, which includes 70 km range Agni 1, 3000 km range Agni 3, Agni 4 and Agni 5. Agni 2 is 2000 km strike range. It has a strike range of 2000 km. It is a surface-to-surface medium range nuclear capable missile. It is an intermediate range ballistic missile. It is a two-stage missile equipped with advanced high accuracy navigation system. It is propelled by solid rocket propellant system.